Welcome to Trust TV. I'm your host, Dhruv Kular. The growing field of digital therapeutics harnesses the power of technology to offer new and exciting treatments. But can we trust that our data will be kept secure and that these technologies will deliver on their therapeutic promise? For answers to these questions and more, I'm joined by Peter Hames, CEO of Big Health, a digital health company that delivers app-based behavioral treatment. Peter, thank you so much for being here with us today.
Great pleasure.
What is digital therapeutics?
I would say that there are three main components which mark out, you know, what I view as true digital therapeutics. So the first of which, perhaps obviously, is, you know, software driven. You know, that's a really key component of the way in which, you know, the therapeutic operates. Second is the very fact that their goal is therapeutic, that they are setting out to prevent, manage or treat, you know, a medical disorder. You know, that has to be the stated purpose for the solution. And then finally, is that they are evidence-based.
Thinking about algorithms and software to treat disease, how is that similar and how is that different than the drugs and the devices that we use or have used for many decades already?
Yeah, so one of the things that most excites me about digital therapeutics is this opportunity to harness the immense scalability and consistency of software. You know, drugs have had a monopoly on scalable, affordable, consistently deliverable, evidence-based healthcare. If we can create, you know, fully software-driven therapeutics, they have a lot of those same qualities.
What are the mechanisms by which we get to a place where we have that type of trust in the software and the algorithms that we use to treat disease?
It's absolutely critical that we, you know, as a digital therapeutics industry, invest the time and resources in building that trust. You know, and without that, we have nothing. Very simply, you know, I think if a therapeutic is a therapeutic, you know, you need to put it through the same level of rigor of testing that you would irrespective of whether or not it's a device, a drug, or a piece of software.
Do you think that the digital therapeutics industry as a whole is doing enough to subject itself to this type of scrutiny and this level of evidence, or are we not quite there yet?
So I think that it's still a very young industry. I think that we are right at the point of defining standards against which this new industry can operate. But we will need to innovate in the models of evidence collection, right, to really be able to properly react to the particular qualities of digital therapeutics.
Over time, like, who is going to be responsible for helping us understand what are high quality digital therapeutics and what is just something that someone has thrown in the app store without any evidence at all?
I would say today, you know, the obvious answer is regulatory agencies, right? And so agencies like the FDA or the MHRA in Europe. But I would say that there are other ways in which, you know, we have found and we're seeing in market that, you know, that trust being conveyed in a really easy to understand way. I think there's going to be, that's by way of illustration, a number of different kind of stamps that will help, I think, people, members of the public, differentiate. The regulatory agencies are an obvious answer, but I think there's going to be a whole bunch of others that will, in aggregate, you know, I'll make it easy for members of the public to go, okay, that's very different. That's clearly in the world of healthcare and therapeutics versus this stuff.
So I think one thing that a lot of people think about when they think about digital therapeutics and giving their data to apps and software developers is their personal health data going to be kept secure and private?
It's a really, really critical component of digital therapeutics reaching their potential. My view is that, you know, data breach, like privacy breaches, are the equivalent of like adverse events in drugs. Like, I think they're going to be as destructive to trust in the public domain as they should be. You know, I think that you cannot invest enough in privacy and data security.
Well, Peter, thank you so much for being here. This has been a great conversation.
Fantastic. Well, thanks for having me.